It's good to be back in the house of the Lord once again. Thank Him for another day He's given us. We just want to praise His holy name. I always do this. I guess you all know my style. I always like to raise my hands and praise the Lord, Brother Roger.
Amen.
I tell you what, I can't do nothing without Him. Amen. He's been good to me. He's blessed me down through the years. I sit there thinking about this church here. Been in here a lot of times. Been in here in a lot of good meetings, Martha. Remember back years ago, people used to shout, praise the Lord. But you know, we've kind of got in a place where it's kind of quiet anymore when you go to the house of the Lord sing, right? Not very many praises on people's hearts.
That's right.
The Bible tells us everything that has breath, praise ye the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. So we're going to come here tonight. We come to worship Him in spirit and in truth. We come to praise His holy name tonight because He is worthy of our praises.
Yes, amen. Sir. Amen.
And I praise God for that. You know, we can do nothing within ourselves, but it's by and through the grace of God. We are what we are. That's what Brother Paul said. And we're glad that you've given us an invitation to come over here again. And like I said, it's been a long time since we've been over here, but we can remember all those good times we had here.
Yeah, we had some good memories.
Remember one time we was over here in a revival years ago. Brother Earl Woods is over here preaching a revival. I can't remember what night it was, but the Spirit come down and blessed, and people got to testify, and poor Brother Earl didn't even get to preach that night. Now that's a good meeting, amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. You know, it can still happen today, children. We can still have good meetings like we used to. But you know, the devil can rob you of about everything else, but he can't rob you of those fond memories, those good times you had in the house of the Lord. Amen. Glad I'm saved, don't you, folks?
Amen.
I'm glad I know the Lord. Tonight, we'll try to preach us a little message here. The Lord's kind of laid this on our heart. Just debating on what to preach. We're sitting out there on the back porch. I like to get out by myself when I meditate. I like to get out where I can't hear anything. I just like to be where it's right real quiet. And that's the way the Lord can really work with you and get a hold of you. And the Lord kind of give us a message here tonight. If you have your Bibles, turn with us to the book of Genesis. Pretty familiar scripture. The book of Genesis, chapter 32. We're going to start reading down here at verse number 24. All those that will and can, stand for the reading of the word of the Lord. And may he add his blessings on the word of God here tonight. The Bible said in Genesis chapter 32, verse number 24. The Bible said, and Jacob was left alone, and there wrestled a man with him until the breaking of day. And when he saw that he prevailed not against him, he touched the hollow of his thigh. And the hollow of Jacob's thigh was out of joint as he wrestled with him. And he said, let me go, for the day breaketh. And he said, I will not let thee go, except thou bless me. And he said unto him, what is thy name? And he said, Jacob. And he said, thy name shall be called no more Jacob, but Israel.
Yeah.
For as a prince hast thou power with God and with men, and hast prevailed. And Jacob asked him and said, tell me, I pray thee, thy name. And he said, wherefore is it that thou dost ask after my name? And he blessed him there. Amen. And Jacob called the name of the place Peniel, for I have seen God face to face. Amen. Hallelujah tonight.
Yeah, amen.
And my life is preserved. And as he passed over Peniel, the sun rose upon him, and he hollowed upon his thigh. Therefore the children of Israel eat not of the shine with shame, which shrank, which is upon the hollow of the thigh, unto this day, because he touched the hollow of Jacob's thigh in the shinim that shrank. Praise the Lord. You may be seated. That's all we'd like to read. May the Lord add his blessings to the reading of the word here tonight. You know, we was reading this scripture here this evening, and was thinking about Jacob wrestling with that angel of the Lord. You know, folks, I'm in this thing to win, ain't you? You know, a lot of times we look around us, we see in our churches, a lot of people was in there at one time. But we look around, we don't see them anymore. They've quit. They've turned their back on the Lord. I know, probably you all too, I've had family that was in church years ago, but now they've quit. They've turned around and turned their back on the Lord, Brother Daniel. It saddens my heart to know this thing.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you, children, just like old Jacob, he had it in his heart that he was going to win that wrestling match.
Yeah.
Amen. He wrestled with that angel all night long, and it's probably up in the morning about daybreak when they got done wrestling. But listen, folks, I'm in this thing. I'm going to win it, Brother Roger. If I have to wrestle from now to the end of my life, I'm going to make it through. Amen.
Bless him, Lord. Yeah.
And I hope you do too. Amen.
Amen. Help him, Lord.
We see a lot of people that's turned and gone. And their churches today seem like friends. Now, if you want to shout, you let her roll. Hey, you can just praise the Lord too, amen. Hallelujah. I'm happy here tonight, ain't you?
Bless him, Lord.
Bless him, Lord.
I'm glad I'm saved, folks. I'm glad to know the Lord, amen.
Amen, amen.
I'm in this thing to win, Brother Daniel. I tell you what, friends, the old devil's going to try to rip you down. He's going to try to tear you down. He's going to do everything under the sun to get you to quit wrestling, amen. He'll get you to quit going on for the Lord, Brother Roger. I tell you what, it's a battle every day, friends. I face old Satan most every day of my life, amen. I'll tell you what, but I ain't giving up, Sister Martha.
Amen. Hang in there, boy.
This reminds me of a lot of these old timers that used to come over here to this church. Them old timers. They fought a good fight. They kept the faith. And they finished their course. Amen. I want to be that way too, Brother Daniel,
amen.
Don't you? I want to see all of us go to children. Amen. I want to see us all make it to that glorious city. But I'm afraid that staying there we live in, my friends, the churches is getting cold. They're a drawing back. They're a compromising on this. They're a compromising on that. But I'll tell you one thing, old Jim ain't compromising on nothing, amen. I'll tell you what, God told me to preach the gospel, and that's what I'm going to do. They say don't preach too loud, don't get excited, don't preach too long, Brother Roger. But listen, if the Lord sends me up here to preach, I'm going to stand here and preach till I get on, amen.
Bless him, Lord.
Our churches is too quiet today, children. I tell you what, somebody's going to be responsible for some of this stuff that's going on, this false doctrine stuff that's going around, amen. Somebody's going to be held accountable for that. We'll get to that in just a minute. I'm happy tonight, ain't
Bless
you,
him, Lord. Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I'm glad I'm saved, children. Well, this is what the Lord's leading. I didn't know which way I was going. We look at our churches today, friends. We're few in number, ain't we? But the Bible says, where there's two or more gathered in my name, I'll be in the midst. Hey, that don't take but you and the Lord, amen? That's two, ain't it? Hallelujah, Brother Roger. I've had some good times out here on these old mountains in my track and dozer, amen.
Yeah, bless you,
just sitting on my riding lawnmower. Run off the bank one day, but I ain't going to say nothing about that. Woo, hallelujah. I'm glad I'm saved.
Yeah.
I used to. Was pretty quiet about preaching. I didn't get too excited. But I tell you anymore, when the Spirit gets hold of you, Brother Daniel, you can't stand it, can you?
Bless him, Lord.
Amen. There's a lot of people quenches the spirit anymore, even in their churches anymore. So maybe they're supposed to be in a shout and they sit there and not say a word. Amen. Hey, listen, children. Ain't you glad you're saved tonight? Yeah. Ain't you glad you're a Christian? Ain't you glad you're a child of God? A chosen priesthood? A royal priesthood? Folks, we are to be a happy bunch of people tonight. Amen. Yeah. I'm glad you saved me, ain't you, Martha? Yeah. Hallelujah tonight.
I'm glad. Amen.
Hello. If people would just mind the spirit, we could see some good times like we used to here in this old church. Hallelujah. Everything just break loose and let her go, amen. Yeah. Set man aside. Do a little wrestling. Maybe that helped us, amen. Praise the Lord tonight, children. Listen. They've got to where they put their King James Version's Bible up. So they're carrying laptops now.
Amen.
Seen the beat anymore?
Haven't seen that.
Bless it, Jesus.
Amen. Hey, if I can't get it out of this thing right here, I don't want it out of nothing else. Amen.
Right. Amen. Come on.
Hey, they say, well, about the King James Version's in that laptop. What else is in that laptop? Hey, you don't see me coming through the door there with a King James Version and a Playboy book in my back pocket, do you? Folks, we got to keep the house of God clean, amen.
Amen.
We've got to respect the house of God anymore.
Yeah.
People's lost the respect for the house of the Lord much anymore. I was down over in Allegheny, went and visited a church over there. This preacher got up, boy, he was all decked out, and he had that laptop there, and he had everything wrote down on a piece of paper. I said, boys, this ain't gonna work. I'd rather listen to television than that. Hallelujah. Folks, this old world ain't getting no better.
No, it's
and don't you right. Look for it to get no better either, because the Bible says it ain't going to. The Bible says it'll wax worse and worse. Amen. So let's just hold on to what we got, and we can make it on through by the help of Jesus Christ. The Bible says the same endureth to the end, the same shall be saved. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I don't know, I get aggravated sometimes. I get down and out and get weary. But I ain't quitting.
Bless
I'm still a wrestling. I ain't a quitting. I said, Lord, just bless me one more time. Let you know. Let me know. I know sometimes he'll let them blessings go by once in a while, Brother Daniel. But hey, he ain't forgot you. God ain't out yonder nowhere. God's right here with us tonight, children.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you something else. He's still alive, amen.
Yeah.
A lot of people thinks he's dead, Daniel.
Yeah.
God thinks God's way out yonder somewhere. He's right here in our midst tonight, children.
Amen.
He's right here. I couldn't be up here preaching this gospel if he wasn't here to help me, amen.
Help him, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Bless him.
Sometimes we set him short, don't we, children? We just don't depend on him like we ought to. Amen. I know sometimes I've done that. I said, well, I can handle this myself. I can take care of this. Found that the biggest mistake I ever made.
Amen.
Amen. When you just turn it over to God. I know I've got lost people, and you have too. I know God, you know, he'll save me in his own time, be his will, but they've got to come. But we want to still preach the gospel to them. Hey, I ain't buttering up for nobody. I don't care if it's family. I don't care for who it is. Well, you ought to talk to them like that. Hey, listen, if you don't tell them the truth, brother, they ain't going to get saved, amen.
Amen.
The Bible said the truth will set you free, and the Bible said free indeed you are, amen.
Yeah.
And I still preach, if you die in your sins, you're going to that awful place. Ain't no way out of it. I've met people that don't believe that. I've met people that thinks if you die in your sins, God's still going to save you. God's still going to take you to heaven. If you read the book of Corinthians, it'll plainly tell you that the Bible said there'll be no sin in heaven, amen. For whatever excuse they come up with.
Oh, my friends, you can see how they're wallering the scripture around today, wallering the word of God around to make it fit their situation, or maybe to soothe their consciences where it won't bother them no more, Brother Roger. But if I'll tell you what, I'm still going to preach Jesus Christ and Him crucified, and I'm going to preach, if you die in your sins, you're going to that awful place.
Yes. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Brother, it scares me to death sometimes when I get out of the will of the Lord and I let it go for 2 or 3 days, and the Bible plainly tells you, be you angry and sin not. But it also says right away, don't let the wrath go down on, don't let the sun go down on your wrath.
That's right.
A lot of people let it go too long. You know why? The longer you let it go, the easier it is to do away with it. The easier it is to let it go. Let it go. Just let it keep building up. And the conscience has quit working today, seem like, for children. I tell you what. The Bible says to fear God and keep His commandments. That's the whole duty of man. The whole duty of man. I fear this man named God, don't you?
Yeah.
Not that he's a mean God, but he's a God of wrath. He's a God of love. They preach God of love anymore.
Yeah.
They don't preach a God of wrath anymore. He saved me from that wrath, amen? He saved you from that wrath that's going to come up on this old world. It's a pitiful world we live in, folks. Seems like every day you can hear some of Satan's work going on. In one way or another. My friend Satan is out there working. And he's doing a good job. He's tearing people's homes apart. He's filling their heads with these old drugs they got. Filling their mouths with this old liquor and booze they got. Filling people's ears with things they oughtn't to listen to.
Yeah.
I tell you what, children, better be careful what you listen to. Amen, because it can have an effect on you.
Amen.
If a devil can sneak just a little bit in there, in your ear, he can start working for me.
Yeah.
My friends, we've got to be careful this day and era we live in. He's out there deceiving and being deceived. People, who's he after? There's some bunch sitting right here. Me, you, and you all. That's who he's after, children. Mm-hmm. That's who he's going to work the hardest on, amen? But I tell you what, if you've got Jesus, friend, you've got somebody to help you.
Yeah.
I mean, it can come. Like I said a while ago, I've seen people in the house of God that turned their back, quit walking with the Lord. Turned her back and went back out into the world, just like Demas did there on Brother Paul. He said he loved the things of the world more than what Paul had taught him. Read over in the scriptures, Timothy there, Brother Paul was telling him, he says, in the latter days they will not endure sound doctrine.
That's right.
Amen. You look around you today, you can see that. You can see they're not enduring sound doctrine, but they're going
right.
Something that itchy stuff to soothe their ears. Something to cover their conscience up a little bit. Amen. But I tell you what, children, there's still a good bunch of preachers around here. There's still a good bunch of preachers, and there's still a good bunch of deacons down here. It's sticking with this word, brother, and they ain't a turning their back on it, and they ain't a compromising the way the world is today.
That's
what we need. Oh, I could probably gain a lot of popularity, Brother Roger, and you could too if you go out here and doctor this thing up a little and preach it the way they want it, amen? You could probably get a bunch of people, Daniel. But listen, it ain't going to do you no good. It ain't going to do you no good, and it ain't going to do them no good. It's going to make matters
that's
worse.
That's the truth.
That's right.
Hallelujah. Let me read you a little something. Ezekiel, the Bible said, Son of man, I have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel. Therefore hear the words of my mouth, and give them warning for me.
give them warning for me. When I say unto you, wicked, thou shalt surely die. Them some strong words, ain't they? Mm-hmm. A lot of people will turn that around and butter it up right real good and try to make it say something that it ain't supposed to say, amen?
Yeah.
But friends, like I said, if you die in your sins, you're going to that awful place. Listen, thou shalt surely die, and thou givest him not warning, nor speaketh to warn the wicked from his wicked ways to save his life. The same wicked man shall die in his iniquity, but the blood will I require at thy hand.
Yeah. Amen.
Amen.
Folks, I don't want nobody's blood dripping off my hands. Do you?
No.
No. I've read that a lot of times ever since I've been a preacher. And that's stuck in my mind. Friends, I'm accountable for this message here. I'm accountable for people's lives. But listen, if I'll tell them the truth and they turn not from their iniquities, then their blood is required at their hand and you've cleared yourself. But praise be to God, if you tell them that it's wrong for sin to enter in and they turn from their iniquities, their soul will be saved, amen. That's what our responsibility is, your children. Yeah. That we should see the lost saved today, amen.
Amen. Yeah, saved out of sin, not in it.
Amen. I say, I was preaching here a while back, and I said, this ain't no easy job. Sometimes it gets pretty tough, don't Brother Roger? Daniel.
Sometimes.
But listen, children. The Bible said that if you warn the wicked and he turn not from his wickedness nor from the wicked way, he shall die in his iniquity. But thou hast surely delivered thy soul. That's your soul. The Bible said, again, when the righteous man doth turn from his righteousness and commit iniquity, and I lay a stumbling block before him, he shall die, because thou hast not given him warning. He shall die in his sins, and the righteous which he hath done shall not be remembered, but his blood will I require at your hand. Who's he talking to right here? He's talking to the children of Israel. He's talking to the righteous people, amen, supposedly. But God had commissioned Ezekiel there to go tell my people, go warn my people. It's the same way today, children. We preaching, we warn the people, amen. You don't hear much preaching about sin anymore. You don't hear much preaching about going to hell anymore, or that awful place where Satan and his angel is at, amen. I guess they're afraid to run some of them off, don't you? Hallelujah. You know, I've been to a few churches, pretty nice churches, and I preach just like I always do, and I don't cut no corners. I've noticed they're not, they ain't biting me back in a long time. Hey, I guess I got to somebody, amen. Hey, went to this one church, a friend of mine said, now when 12 o'clock woman, this certain woman, when 12 o'clock comes, she gets up and leaves. I was standing up there preaching. I know who he's talking about. I was almost done. She got up. I said, well, it must be 12 o'clock. I just kept preaching. Amen. The Lord wasn't done with me yet. That's a problem, seem like today, folks. The church is in such a big way or in a hurry to do something else, but sitting in the house of God, hey, they ain't getting no blessing, and they ain't going to get any, amen.
Yeah, yeah, happy Lord.
Glad to be here tonight, children. Thank God for his mercy and grace. Thank God. He said that mercy and grace shall endure forever. It ain't going to run out, Brother Roger.
Amen.
I still need grace today. I still need mercy today, children. You do too. That's why we come boldly before the throne of grace, to obtain this mercy, to help, to obtain this grace in a time of need, Children, there's ever been a time that we as Christians stand in need of the day and hour we live in. This world is getting wickeder and wickeder every day.
That's the truth.
And children, we ought to grow stronger and stronger as the world gets wickeder and wickeder. Amen. Just turn it right around. Let's get stronger. They're going to get wickeder and wickeder. Where sin doth abound, the Bible says grace does much more. Amen. So we still got hope. We still got a change in this world. Amen. I'm going to hold on. I'm going to try to endure to the end. Amen. Children, it's good to be a child of God, ain't it?
Amen.
I'm glad I'm saved, amen. I thank God for that. But Ezekiel, Lord, he spoke a truth to him. He said, but Ezekiel, I'm going to tell you something before I send you. They ain't going to listen to you. Yet he had to tell him to go and warn them people. He said, they're a stiff-necked, rebellious kind of people. They ain't going to listen to you. Same way today, Fred, Brother Roger, Daniel, we preached the gospel all these times, and they're still not listening to us. Amen.
Amen.
Still stiff-necked, still rebellious. Sometimes, once in a while, somebody will give in and listen to the word. Said, the Bible said, harden not your hearts in day of provocation, that you might hear the word of God and get saved. God don't want nobody to be lost, children. God don't want to see nobody die and go to hell. It's not his will that any should perish, but all should come to repentance. Amen. I wished everybody would come, Brother Roger, don't you? I wish the whole world would come. But that's not the way it is. That's not the way it's set up. Amen. And many his will has come and can find grace and mercy in this day that we live in. You know, they're looking to everything else but God, amen?
Amen.
They're looking to everything else. Like I said, drugs, alcohol, whatever. Anything else but God, seems like. Hallelujah. The Bible said, nevertheless, if thou warn the righteous man that the righteous sin not, most notice he said righteous, and he doth not sin, he surely shall live. Because he is warned, also thou hast delivered thy soul. Amen. Children, we're living in a day and hour and a time. Seem like I can look back over life. Been saved several years. I can see a big change. Even in our churches, I can see a big change here in Ashe County. God has not changed, but the people has changed, Brother Daniel.
Amen.
Things that they used to look on that was sin, it don't bother them no more. They don't look at it as sin. They call it a sickness. Amen. To me, brother, it's sin. I don't care what to say.
Always will be.
And I'll say again, children, I'm not trying to get into politics or anything, but some of our forefathers that wrote the Constitution of the United States could look and see what the Supreme Court has done today. It'd probably make them sick at their stomach if it's still alive. I'd have never thought that our Supreme Court would have done what they done, approving this gay marriage thing. Friends, we're right on the brink of Sodom and Gomorrah, if you'll have it. But listen, children, if you're a child of God, you're saved. You're on your way to heaven. Whether you go by the grave or by the appearing of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, amen. That's the hope we've got in this wicked world today. Seems like there's not much good news anymore. There's always bad news, murders, killing, this and that. But listen, children, there's coming a day when that man said to them boys standing there, hey, you men of Galilee, why stand you here looking into the skies?
That same Jesus that you saw go away is coming back. In like manner. Hallelujah for that. I wish he'd come back tonight, don't you? Amen.
Amen.
Take us out of this wicked world. And I'll say again, folks, he's alive and he's doing well. Amen. And guess what he's doing right now? On mine and your behalf. We prayed here a while ago, didn't we? He heard every prayer that we prayed. And he's up there making intercession between us and God for me and you. Hey, that's pretty personal, ain't it? Amen? I'm glad he's up there. But listen, we need to hang on this thing, folks, till it's over. And it's not over yet. We're going to have to do some enduring. We're going to have to do some suffering. And we're going to go through some trials. And we're going to go through a bunch of temptations. Amen.
Yeah.
But we can make it, children. Mm-hmm. We can make it. Not on our own. Not with our self-righteousness. But it's by the mercy and grace that God's given us. Hallelujah here tonight, children. Ain't you glad you're saved? Ain't you glad you know Jesus? Amen.
Amen.
Ain't you glad? Because my friends, he gave me that peace I didn't have before. I'd lay my head on the bed, Brother Daniel, and I'd worry about this, I'd worry about that, worry about what I'd done or what I'd said to somebody. But listen, children, I can lay my head down now. And that peace comes, Sister Martha, and I don't have to worry about that stuff no more. Because God forgive me of all that stuff that I used to do. And he told me, he said, son, I'll throw her in the sea of forgetfulness, never to be brought up before you again. Amen. Ain't you glad of that, folks, for that old meanness we used to do? God forgive you for it, and he cast it away out of the sight of us all. Amen.
Amen.
But we're accountable for what we do from here on out, though.
Amen.
We're still accountable. Some people seem to think that's it. That's all you need to do. But I'm sorry, friends. But like I said, he that it doeth to the end. Now, friends, there's still a lot of work, a bunch of work to be done. There's still a lot of prayers to be prayed. And there's still a lot of things that we need to do. We don't sit down. We don't quit. We keep moving forward. We keep moving forward. Amen. You can't stand in one place all the time. If you do, your feet sink in the ground. Amen. But listen. He that endureth to the end, the same shall be saved. Amen. Listen, children. Bible said this, know also, that in the last days perilous times shall come. Amen. You know, I've heard this preach when I was a little boy growing up. I didn't know what's talking about. I didn't know what this talking about. I thought I was having a good time. Amen. But when you come to reality, folks, when you come to realize what's around you and your surroundings, you know that there is perilous times. Amen. There's no... God didn't promise me no easy way out. He didn't you either. He said you'll have bumps. You'll have potholes to run through going down this highway of holiness. Amen. But he said, don't turn, don't bear to the right, don't bear to the left. Mm-hmm. Go straight.
Amen.
There's too many people are burying now. I mean Christians, supposed to be Christians, burying this way or burying that way. That's why they didn't endure sound doctrine in this day and era we live in, amen? That's about the truth, amen? If you ain't got a doctrine you don't like, you can go to about any church you want to and find you one you might like. Do you know that?
They're out there.
They're out there, Brother Roger, ain't they? Man, some of this stuff is just ridiculous. Man, when I get to listen, when I hear it, I cut it off right quick. Because I don't want it to go in my ear. I don't want to hear it. Amen? Well, I'm still preaching Jesus Christ and Him crucified, ain't it? Amen? That's what got me saved. The Bible said you're begotten by what? The Word.
Amen.
The Word. They're trying a little bit of everything now. Do you know that? If we could just get them in. Maybe just slip a little bit of the world out there and let them come to it, you know, and then we'll drag them in. I tell you what, if it works like that, the little world will drag them right back out, amen. You drag them back out. The Bible said, be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind.
Amen.
You know, they can have all this worldly stuff they want. I don't want nothing to do with it. I'm glad, folks, like I said a while ago, they still some good preachers sitting around here, some good people that worship God. Still believe in this whole time salvation, don't you? Still believe that the power of God can save people's souls if they don't only come. Amen. I know I've got lost people, and you have too. But I'm still going to tell them the truth, children. Because I know if I don't, their blood can be required at my hands. Amen. I know some people say, well, you're harsh. I said, no, I'm not. I said, I'm just telling the truth. I'm telling the truth. Amen. But listen. The Bible says, for men shall be lovers of themselves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful and unholy. Hallelujah. Without natural affection, truth breakers, false accusers, in contentment, fierce, despisers of those that are good. You know, I thought about that the other day. A lot of people don't have much respect for a preacher anymore. Do you know that?
That's right.
Used to people had respect for a preacher, for a deacon in the church. Well, I tell you what, children, I pray, I don't care where I'm at, I thank God for my meal when I sit down. I was up at a restaurant there the other morning, this old boy is sitting right behind me. He's supposed to be in a church going. I pulled my hat off and I'm sitting there praying. I don't know who prayed the loudest. Me or him a talking, amen. But he didn't have enough respect there to keep his mouth shut till I got done praying, amen. That's all right, I just kept a praying, amen. That's why I say they don't have much respect for preachers no more.
That's right.
Some people have, some don't. Amen, but listen. Having a form of godliness. Having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof. We see when Ezekiel was called, the children of Israel had a form of godliness, didn't they? But they denied the power of. God knew they wouldn't listen to Ezekiel, just like Moses. They wouldn't listen to him either. Same way he is today. A lot of people just don't listen. They turn a deaf ear. Amen. Listen. Bible said, for this sort are they which creep into houses and lay silly women laden with sin, led away with divers lust. Ever learning and never
coming to the truth.
Able to come to the knowledge of the truth. I would like to say that there's probably people in the house of God today that sit under preaching years after year, time after time, but they've never come to the actual knowledge of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. They've done it so long. They get used to it. It don't bother them much no more. But I'm glad, folks, when the Word of God is being preached to me, if it gets on my toes, if it gets on my back, or wherever it lands, I'm glad it, it works that way, amen.
Amen.
I'm glad that it still works, Brother Roger, because the power of God will straighten you out. He'll straighten you up and make you walk right. He'll make you talk right. And Brother Rex said he'll make you smell right too, amen.
Amen.
That's what it is. It's for reproof and correction, amen. I'm glad it corrects me once in a while, don't you?
Amen.
Some people says they've never sinned, they've never done nothing wrong. I'm afraid they're telling you to flee away.
Amen.
Bible said always come short of sin. Always come short of the glory of God. Amen. We're all out to go wrong. Amen. We're all out to mess up. But I'll tell you what, little children, he said, I tell you not to sin, but he said, if you sin, you have an advocate with the Father, amen, which is righteous.
Amen.
A lot of people, their altars are about growed up. One place talks about thistles growing around. Briars, thistles, because they ain't used no more, amen. Bible said, yea, and all that hath that will live godly in Jesus Christ shall suffer persecutions. Bible said, but evil men and seducers shall wax worse and worse.
That's true.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I've got an amen out of that. But listen, deceivers and being deceived. But listen, children, the Bible said, but continue thou in the things which thou hast learned and hast been assured of,
amen,
knowing of whom thou hast learned them, amen. I'm glad it comes from above, don't you, Roger?
Amen.
Oh, I can tell you one thing, folks. There's some people around here that can cook up a good sermon, or they can cook up a good Sunday school lesson, my friend, and make her just sound just as pretty as you ever seen. But I tell you what, there just ain't no power in it, amen.
That's right, true.
Having assurance that you've learned these things, having assurance that you know where they come from, that you know where they come from above through a good man of God, amen, that we have listened to down through the years. I've heard a lot of good preachers in my lifetime. I've heard a lot of good preaching. And I'll tell you what, it's getting the job done today just like it was years ago, amen.
Amen.
Maybe not as many, but it's still getting the job done. Listen, I'll try to hurry along here. But continue thou in the things which thou hast learned and hast been assured of, knowing of whom thou hast learned them. You know, we don't put our faith in a man, because man will let you down. Mm-hmm. Man will befriend you. But I know a man, his name is Jesus, greatest friend I've ever had in my life, Brother Roger. And I can't think of a time, ladies, that he's ever let me down. I've let him down, but he's never let me down. Amen.
Amen.
He's done everything he said he would. He's kept every promise he's promised me. Hallelujah. And I'll tell you what, children, I'm glad of this promise. If I make it through the end, he's promised me eternal life. Mm-hmm. He's promised me a heaven, a home in heaven, where I can go over there and see all those old saints of God that's trotted this path before me, done their work, and kept the faith, and finished the course. I'll be able to see them. But most of all, friends, you're going to meet that man named Jesus, the man that came down here and saved your soul, mm-hmm, the man that hung on that cross there between the heavens and the earth. Oh, children, what a scornful they done him, how they treated him. But they didn't know there was a Savior coming unto them.
A man named Jesus. There was no guile found in his mouth, Brother Roger.
That's right.
A lamb, perfect without spot, spot or blemish, slain from the foundation of the world. Amen. Oh, how I wish we could get people to believe that. Amen. How would people to know that. Amen. I'm glad for salvation, ain't you? I ain't got religion, I got salvation. The Bible says only salvation comes from God. Religion comes from everywhere else, don't it? Most time it's men. But I'm glad, children, this church is still here. I'm glad to see you all here tonight. Glad to be here tonight, amen. I feel a good spirit, amen. You know, like I said a while ago, the devil can rob you of a lot of things, but it can't rob you of them fine memories that you had in the house of God. Fond memories of them old brothers and sisters. Years ago, I used to shout in this church, get happy, run up and down aisles. I never forget that. Never forget those things. Amen. Sometimes I get down and out and weary, and I think about some of the good times that the Lord's blessed me with. Amen. That helps, don't it? That helps. He's good to us, children, ain't he? He's good to us. Amen. And I thank God for each and every breath that I breathe. I thank God for being here tonight. Amen. Because if it wasn't for him, children, I wouldn't be here. And if it wasn't for him, you wouldn't be here.
Amen.
Amen. So let's just praise the Lord tonight. Amen. Praise his holy name. He's good to us. Children, the Bible tells us we're just pilgrims and strangers passing through a strange land, looking for a better country, looking for a better place. This is not our home, friends. It's temporary. You might own a bunch of land, you might own a whole lot of stuff. But I tell you, you're just renting it for a while. Because when you die, you leave it behind.
Amen.
You leave it behind. Amen. We don't gain nothing down here. I got to where I don't want much anymore. Seem like the more you got, the more problems you got. Amen. And it's good. God's been good to me. He's blessed me with work. He's blessed me with about everything I need. I used to think I wanted a lot of money. But I found out, I said, Lord, just give me enough to keep my family fed and clothes on my back and away to go. That's all I want. I don't want no more. Because it seemed like the Bible said that the more you got, the more problems you're going to have. Listen, Paul's Bible says here, Paul's talking to Brother Timothy here. Paul said, I charge thee before God and the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall judge the quick and the dead at his appearing and his kingdom. The Bible said, preach the word. Be instant in season and out of season. Reprove, rebuke, exalt with all long suffering and doctrine. Doctrine. Not doctrines, doctrine.
Amen.
Folks, I'm glad this old doctrine's still around, ain't you? I'm glad it's still here. Like I said a while ago, they're twisting it, they're turning it every which way to suit your own needs. But I thank God for the real, true doctrine today. Amen. Hallelujah. It makes me feel good. It helps me, friends. It helps me to live in this wicked old world. The Bible said, for the time will come where they will not endure sound doctrine, but offer to their lust shall be heaped to themselves, teachers, having itching ears. Amen. Well, if you want to have a crowd, if you want to have a big church, try that. It might work. Now, don't get me wrong, there's probably some that does good. But a lot of them's out for the filthy lure.
Preaching what it said.
I'm not in it for the money, friends. I'm not in it for the popularity. Because I know I ain't going to have neither one of them.
But I'm in it, my friends, because the Lord told me to preach the gospel. He said, proclaim my word that we might see the church edified, that we might edify one another, that we could be uplifted, helped, and that we could see souls saved. Amen. But we're going to preach the gospel just the way the book says it is. I'm not adding nothing to it. I'm not taking anything away from it. Because if you're reading Revelations, it'll tell you what will happen if you do these things.
Yeah.
That's dangerous. A lot of people don't pay that much attention to it. A lot of people says, well, once my name's in there, it can't be taken out. Excuse me. Read Revelations chapter 22. It said, if any man added to this or take away from it, his name will be taken out of the Lamb's book of life.
That's right.
My friends, you ain't going to heaven if your name ain't in that book. If your name ain't wrote down in that book, you're not going in there. Your reservations is canceled today, amen. Mm-hmm. I want to make sure mine's in there, Brother Roger, and I want to make sure that it stays in there, amen. Because I've been in it too long, I've got too much invested. I don't want to turn back now. Amen. Okay, we'll try to hurry. I don't know what time it is. You notice I never wear a watch. The Bible said, and they shall turn away their ears from the truth, and they shall be turned into fables. But watch thou in all things, endure afflictions, do the work of an evangelist. Make full proof of thy ministry. I want you to listen to what Paul says right here. The Bible says, I am now ready to be offered. My time of departure is at hand. Folks, there's coming a day in each one of us's life that's going to be said. Don't know what day it'll be. Don't know what night it'll be. But there's coming, friends. Your time of departure is going to be at hand.
Amen.
Amen.
My friends, we're all going to die. We're going to die unless the Lord comes back. I was thinking about that too, what a blessing it is to know that you're a Christian and you don't have to worry about that day. You don't have to worry about that day. You know, my friends, if you can lay your head down on the pillow of the night and go to sleep, not have to worry about your situation if you don't wake up. Ain't that comforting?
Amen.
Ain't that a wonderful thought, children? Because I know if I don't wake up, I'm gonna be over yonder with Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Hey, hallelujah. That's a blessing, ain't it? That is a blessing. But we've got to do something to have it that way. Paul said, I fought a good fight. I kept the faith. Therefore, there is a crown of righteousness laid up for me. You notice what Paul said in there in the scripture in one or two places. He said, I die daily. Paul was a good man. He loved God. But you know, Paul had trouble, seemed like every day, on every hand, he had trouble. A lot of them old apostles did.
They were preaching the truth to them.
That's right, Brother Rex, is preaching the truth to them. And my friends, if we're going to preach the truth today, we're going to have problems.
Amen.
Now, I ain't saying you're going to be whipped and beaten and put in jail, but there are people who come up and mouth you. I'll tell you that much right now. But I'll tell you what, them old boys, when they beat them and throw them in prison, Paul and Silas down there that night, long about the midnight hour, I thought about them old prisons back then.
Didn't have no lights in them, did he? Might have had an old lantern or two. I bet they're full of roaches and rats and dirty and nasty. But along about 12 o'clock midnight, Paul and Silas got to praising the Lord and raising their hands up. And hallelujah, the earthquake shook that jail and opened them doors. Amen. Ain't you glad the earthquake come and opened our doors one day wherever you got saved at? Amen. And released you out of that bondage that you were in and kept you, brought you out of the land of Egypt and put your feet in Canaan. Amen. Hallelujah for salvation. I think about old Moses there. When there's a fight with the Amalekites, they held his hands up. He held them up first to start with. That Moses was getting pretty old and he couldn't hold them up there and he dropped them down. Boy, when they raised their hands up, boy, the children of Israel just prevailed like, boy, they'd done good, didn't they? They'd win that victory. But when them hands was dropped, they lost the battle.
Yeah.
Friends, sometimes our hands get weak and we have to lower them a little bit. But praise be to God, there's some good people around here, some good Christian people will come by and get on the right-hand side of you or on the left and help you raise them old feeble hands again. Amen.
And you can have the victory.
Amen.
Satan won't beat you down no more for a while. He'll quit for a while, but he'll be right back, children. I guarantee you that. He'll be right back. But hallelujah. Praise God for our salvation. Children, we're living in perilous times. And like I said a while ago, the Bible said they ain't going to get no better either. The Bible said, therefore, we ought to give a more earnest heed to the things which we have heard, lest at any time we let them slip. Amen. You know, when I go to the house of God, I might not feel good. I might be tired. I might be weak. But I praise God for when I go out that door, I feel a whole lot better when I come in. Amen. Because I've been in the presence of an almighty God, and He's helped me, and He's blessed my soul, and He gave me strength to get out and face old Satan again another day. Amen.
Amen.
Because I surely can't handle him on my own, amen. Bible said, how shall we escape if we neglect so great a salvation, which at first began to be spoken by the Lord and was confirmed to us by them that heard it. Hey, this thing's been around a long time. Been here a long, long, long time. And I'm glad it's still here, children. That's my escape. That's your escape. Because He is our only hope in this world. People's got hope in everything else. But Jesus Christ. You know, I'm glad for salvation, friends, because, you know, as we live here our life, it's a battle every day, as Paul said, he died daily. It's a battle against the flesh, against the spirit, every day of our life. But praise be to God, we can come out with a victory. The Bible said, but therefore remaineth a rest for the people of God. For he that is entered into his rest, he also has ceased from his own works as God did from his. The Bible said, let us labor therefore to enter into his rest, lest any man fall away, the same example of unbelief. For the word is God, for the word of God is quick and powerful,
sharper
than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit,
and of the joints and marrow. And it is a discernment of the thoughts and intents of the heart.
I deny it.
Amen.
You know, God knows our thoughts. And I thank God for that word that's still sharper than any two-edged sword.
Because children, the Bible tells us that it's appointed unto man once to die. After this is judgment. And friends, the Bible also tells me that no one is going to get by that judgment. Every man, every woman is going to have to stand before an almighty God and give an account for the deeds done in this body, whether they be good or whether they be evil.
Yeah.
My friends, we're accountable for that, ain't we? I want to stand there and say, this man right over here is pleading my case. His name's Jesus. He's my lawyer. He'll take care of things.
Yeah.
Because, my friends, you ain't going to be able to say nothing. It ain't going to do you a bit of good if you could. But hallelujah, praise be to God, children, we can make it. We can make it through. I want to win, don't you? I want to win this race. I want to win this thing. The Bible says lay hold on eternal life. Lay hold on salvation. If you never gain nothing in this life, gain salvation. Because, my friends, you ain't going to escape. Mm-hmm. How shall we? Can't. Hallelujah. Okay, children, that's a little message with God's laid on our heart. I hope we haven't kept it too long. But hope we've helped one another here tonight. Hope we've edified this church a little bit. But, friends, we're living in a wicked, perverse world. As I said a while ago. But Jesus is still with us. Jesus will help us. Amen. No matter how tough it gets, no matter how hard it gets, no matter how long that old road gets, Jesus will help us. Amen. I thank God for that. Because, my friends, I'm getting up in years, I'm getting older. And I'm not able to take care of myself like I once did. But I'm glad I still got Jesus. I ask Jesus every morning. I said, Lord, help me today. If I don't ask nothing else, I say, just help me. Take care of me, amen. You know, he always has. Sometimes he's let me get a little warped around a little bit and beat up a little bit. But I thank God that he brought me through it. Amen. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. God's good to us, children, ain't he?
Amen.
I love you and appreciate you, folks. And again, I'll say, I'm glad I'm saved and I'm glad I'm on the way to heaven. Amen. I'm glad you are too. Amen. May the Lord bless you. And we appreciate the invitation over here. And I tell you what's a good place to be here tonight. Been good. Been good. May the Lord bless you. We'll turn it back over to the day.
Bless you, Lord. Yeah.
Amen. Another good service, another good message. It's been a good place to be today.
Yeah.
You know, we started out this morning and had a little singing, and I believed it was going to get better, and I believe it has. We've praised the Lord. We've been blessed to the Lord. The power of God's come down and touched.